So welcome everyone to today's session. Last week, I spoke about feeling tones. So they are typically categorized as pleasant feeling tones, unpleasant, or just no particular feeling, so meaning neutral. Today's session, I would like to emphasize, or I'd like to invite you to really feel or to notice what arises around those feeling tones. When the mind starts to label, oh, this feels unpleasant, and unpleasant can be many things, from feeling sleepy, feeling restless, feeling bored, which are quite normal experiences, or to feeling a bit anxious maybe, or feeling very anxious, or feeling sad, or feeling upset. So the invitation today is to notice what happens when these feeling tones, or when you are experiencing these feeling tones. And I would like to invite you to really notice what thoughts that could be arising. And basically, these are thoughts, emotions, or sensations in the body that may be causing you to feel in a certain way, that are causing you to feel stress, that are causing you to feel unhappy, or having symptoms of depression or feelings of anxiety. And so in meditation, we try to sort of take like a back seat slightly, more like a third party, to just watch and just observe those feelings. Now, people may ask, what is the rationale of just sitting back and just watching these feelings? What we are learning to do is to sit through difficulties, so that when that same feeling sort of emerge in other aspects of our life, we are starting to recondition the mind, or retraining the mind to be able to just sit with that. So if you are triggered in your workplace, maybe somebody said something unnecessary to you. So because we have meditated, we are able to sort of maintain some calm and to say, yeah, it's okay, I can do this, I can, you know, deal with it. And so when we are ready, I would like to just invite you to get into a position that works for you. So some Wednesdays you may prefer to sit, you can also choose to stand, although this session can be about 20 minutes, so you can just, from standing, you can choose to sit halfway, or maybe you want to lie down. So it's something to just bear in mind every Wednesday when you come in. You can play around with different positions. In mindfulness, we always give people a choice, what they want to do, what works for them right now in taking care of yourself. Okay, so now just closing your eyes if you wish, or just keeping them open if you feel more comfortable. Or just lowering the gaze, or just maybe looking outside to the window, where maybe it has a nice scenery for you outside your house or your office. The invitation, of course, is there may be the temptation to look at your emails while sitting through this practice. I would like to encourage you to switch that off and just come here and be for yourself. Not for me, but for yourself. Hold this space for yourself for 20 minutes in a day. Do something for yourself. So moving closer to feeling your breath as you're breathing in and breathing out. Just bringing the attention, the awareness closer to the breath. The breath is very much part of the body. It is part of the body. And so it is a natural anchor for us. And as we are feeling the breath, checking into the posture as well. How are we sitting? Or how are we lying down? Can you feel your legs? Where are they placed? Your hands? Inviting mindfulness to this moment. Connecting with direct reality. Directly connecting with whatever that's here right now for you. Instead of living in your thoughts, in your actions, or your analysis and stories, in a way, unplugging and just connecting, tuning into the present moment. And in the posture, it always helps to sit up as straight as you can so you can stay awake. In meditation, it is about falling awake, not falling asleep. Although some meditations are meant to help you sleep, but this one is meant to help you stay awake, to switch off autopilot and be awake for ourselves. So as we're breathing in and breathing out, going with the flow of the breath, not pushing too hard, not striving for perfection in breathing, not striving to breathe in any particular way. In this mindfulness space, we are learning to accept ourselves for what we are. Coming back to home is what we are cultivating. At this point, you may start noticing that the mind likes to wander. Or maybe it is not wandering, maybe it's feeling very still and calm, and that's okay. Or if you're feeling any emotions that may be arising, or some feelings or sensation. At this point, just acknowledging those feelings and sensations and bringing the mind back to the breath to help us find a steady footing first. We're holding our own space for ourselves, like a container of peace. We're using the breath to keep us grounded and anchored. Having one focus point. If the mind wanders 1,000 times, 100 times, 10 times, 1,000,000 times, just keep bringing the mind back to the breath. It is very normal and natural for the mind to wander. It is a sign of a healthy mind, an imaginative one, a creative one. Here in this space, we're trying to cultivate focus, and so we bring the mind back to the breath. Or if it's helpful for you to just drop in further to the body, and just feeling the body as you're breathing in, breathing out. Following the breath in and following the breath out all the way. Now from the breath, while holding that still in steadiness as best as you can, noticing any thoughts that may be crossing your mind more vividly. Just watching them. Or noticing any emotions that may be arising. Sensations, feelings. If it helps, putting a label to those sensations or feelings. Feeling appreciative, feeling grateful. or feeling frustrated, not feeling well. What does that not feeling well mean? How do you know you're not feeling well? What sensations are arising? The invitation is to tune into those sensations rather than analyze or interpret those sensations. Living in the head, the invitation is to step out of living in the head and just connecting directly with the sensations, just feeling them. Maybe they feel sour or they feel strong, weak, gentle, or feeling tight. You can put a label to them. Pleasant feeling, unpleasant feeling, or not feeling anything. Or something in between, a bit of pleasantness, a bit of unpleasantness, and maybe some feeling of nothingness in between. And that's fine. We are entitled to feel whatever we are feeling right now. And just being with those feelings. Just staying with those feelings, not needing to shut them off or to control them. Not needing to blame other people for having these feelings. Blame your chair or blame the table or blame your computer or your microphone or your headphone. Or to blame me. As best as you can, just noticing those feelings. But of course, if any judgmental thoughts that may be arising, just noticing them and just appreciating them for what they are. Just a thought, just a mental event. Recognizing that we are human. And we may have judgmental thoughts, and it is fine. In mindfulness, we learn to be aware of them, to be aware of how it may compel us to act in a certain way. So now from noticing whether they're pleasant, unpleasant, or just neutral, we go a little deeper. So if there's a feeling of pleasantness, zooming in closer and noticing what thoughts, what body sensations that led to this feeling of pleasantness. So going deeper, closer, what thought, what belief or judgment or analysis led to that feeling of pleasantness or preceded that label of pleasantness. Recognizing it is okay to have such thoughts. So mindfulness is just about being aware, being closely in tune with our body and our mind. And same with unpleasant feeling tones. Zooming in instead of zooming out and running away, but instead getting closer. If it's a feeling of boredom, that label boredom. So noticing what goes around boredom. Maybe a judgment that I need to do something. This is therefore boring. I can't do meditation. And therefore, it is boring. I'm hopeless at meditation. I always fall asleep. Or my mind wanders too much. So noticing what those thoughts are, what those judgments are. How much do you believe in them? And noticing how these thoughts can color your experience. Or just feeling neutral, not feeling anything in particular, just going along with the flow. Sometimes wanting to zone out, sometimes wanting to stay in, sometimes falling off asleep and then waking up suddenly. It is fine, just noticing before you doze off what thoughts are arising, what sensations are you feeling in the body that compel you to want to doze off. Breaking it down, thoughts, emotions, body sensations. Maybe sleepiness is a feeling of heaviness. So noticing that, heaviness led me to consider this sleepiness and therefore an unpleasant feeling. Because there is a desire to want to sit through this meditation without falling asleep. Because the belief is, if I can sit through this meditation without falling asleep, I have achieved something. So just noticing that whole link and assumptions and beliefs, thoughts and emotions. And how this may be making you feel if you are not able to stay awake. Instead, you're nodding off. And how does that make you feel? Does it make you feel like a failure in meditation? So in meditation, there's no right or wrong. Or rather, there is no achievements or failure. It's about just being aware of what's arising and sitting with that. That's all we need to do in meditation. And if we fall asleep, then just wake up again when you are ready. And continue returning to the practice. And now from feeling tones and zooming into our experience, we now zoom out gently, widening our awareness, feeling the room, our body, the contact points of our feet, our hands, and just zooming out. Giving ourselves permission to invite openness to the practice. And as we continue to sit here, I will just read you a poem by Wendell Berry, The Peace of Wild Things. When despair for the world grows in me, and I wake in the night at the least sound, in fear of what my life and my children's lives may be, I go and lie down where the wood drake rests in its beauty on the water, and the great heron feeds. I come into the peace of wild things, who do not tax their lives with forethoughts of grief. I come into the presence of still water, and I feel above me the day-blind stars, waiting with their light for a time. I rest in the grace of the world and am free. I'm just keeping your eyes closed or just softening your gaze still. And in the last few moments of this practice, continuing to keep the space for yourself. Patting yourself on the back for showing up, for soldiering on in this practice. And wishing yourself well. May I be well and be happy. May I rest with grace and resilience. And may everyone in this Zoom space be well and happy. And just wishing everyone well in this community. And opening your eyes when you're ready.